My name is Nizar Al-Baharna. I was the Minister of State for Foreign Affairs in Bahrain. And I have been in Georgetown University for 2 years as a visiting professor. I am with and I've been teaching students, the master students, conflict resolutions and how to avoid conflicts and conflict solutions in conflict zones. Now, conflict resolution usually is done by two methods at the moment, either by force intervention, Iraq, Syria, in a way, Libya, and other places, or by sort of diplomatic mediation. And so far, these two methods have not been very successful. If you look at any conflicts, the conflicts are attributed to usually 6 points. And any conflict cannot get out from the 6 points. Five of them is related to sustainable development, and one is human rights. So if you look at a conflict, it's either political, economical, environmental, social, cultural, which is the sustainable development, or human rights. Or could be a combination of this. Could be all of them, could be two of them, could be three, or could be all of these conflicts. So to solve the conflicts, you have actually to solve the source of the conflict, which are these 6 points. Also, there is another important point. Most of the conflict sort of solutions at the moment are focusing, especially those on mediation, in the two conflicting parties. So they have government and opposition, and they try to solve a problem between them, and they form some sort of peace by allocating certain advantage to one side, say advantage to the other side, etc. But what happens to the people? The people are actually, they are the one who are affected by any conflicts. And if you look at development, they are the source of the tool for development, and they're the target for development. So all the solutions, if they don't actually touch on the population or the people themselves, then these solutions will not be effective. So my work is basically is to focus on sustainable development, on these five issues, which is cultural, economical, social, environmental, and governmental or political, and human rights. And the way is to do that is actually by creating something I call a community development enterprise. So the solution is not political, but it's a combination of all that. And this community development enterprise is just like going into creating communities and working with communities to establish companies. I call them companies or enterprise because they are not political. And there is a method actually of how this company can work, how it's governed. So democracy actually starts within the community, from the community, and they develop it slowly. So the idea, you establish this company in the community, and the company itself is every person who's above 18 years, who's eligible to vote, will have one share in this company. They can actually more if they want, but they own one each one. Then this community, they are like the General Assembly, they elect the board for this company. And so they are actually practicing their election and their sort of democratic system to go into the governance of their community. What does this company do? This company does three things. One, it does all the governmental services. So the government outsources the operation of several ministries to this community company. For example, education, healthcare, roads, you name it, you know, all of these ministries, rather than the ministers do the operation or the ministers do the operation, ministries will only do the legislations. And the operation is outsourced for each part to this community, to this company. So the company actually does these services to the people, governed by the people, run by the people. The second thing that this company does is to offer all the services in the social side, finding jobs, the environmental issues, the cultural within that community, preserving that culture, making people work together, and all of that. Looking at the environment as an issue of vital importance for the sustainability of the economy and also social welfare. And after then the thing is economical side. So this company focuses on economic, creating an economy within that community, etc., etc. And you know, there are methods of to govern, how to govern this company to make sure that there is no violation of the human rights, making sure that every individual has the right, its right or his right. So this is the scheme. I mean, it's in a very, very short way. I mean, it is much more detailed than that. Well, actually, any country who want to be involved in any conflict has always to be part of the solution and not part of the problem. That means it has always to take a middle way, not with this side, not with this side, because then it become be able to provide a solution without actually being siding on one side or not. I think Turkey has a great potential because of not just position of Turkey and closeness on most of these conflicting areas, but I think Turkey can good example of proper governance, etc., etc. And I think if they can adopt the model which I'm talking about, then that could be a good vehicle for a change for a lot of conflicts. Now, let's not just look at places where the conflicts had started, but also they can avoid conflicts that could start in the future. Any country which don't look at the 6 points, they're prone to some sort of conflicts in the future. If we look at Turkey, for example, it was environmental issue with the park when they tried to change this park to a sort of a museum. So it was an environmental issue. People want the park, etc. The government was clever to handle that and to work with the people afterwards to make sure that their requirements are sorted out. So I think, yes, to answer your question, they can play a good role. I think peace are achievable, can be achieved. And this is what we're trying to promote, is that using development, the human rights-based approach, avoid all the kind of political issues, etc., etc., and will create peace, not just in the also in the whole world, because whether we are all connected.